Today we're going to see how trade can expand a country's consumption options beyond what it can produce. We're starting with the country's production possibilities curve, which, recall, shows us all of the combinations of the goods that the country can produce while utilizing its full resources. The negative slope is an indication of the fact that in order to make more of good one, we have to stop making some of good two. So there's always a trade-off in terms of what we put our resources in. The slope of PPC, also recall, has an important interpretation, and that is if we consider some random point, let's say we're starting from here, if we travel to the right by one unit and then travel down, this slope is telling us how many units of good two we have to give up in order to make one more unit of good one. It's also telling us if we give up on a unit of good one, how many units of good two can we make in its stead. In other words, the slope is giving us a cost of good one in units of good two. Notice that the slope varies, so that the slope here, where there are very few units of good one being made, is relatively flat, meaning that the cost of producing the first, second, and third units of good one is quite low, whereas the cost here of producing more units of good one is quite high. And that's another manifestation of the principle of increasing opportunity cost. So, starting from this curve, from the production possibilities curve, let's see what happens when we introduce the possibility of trade. Suppose that on the international market, the two goods have equal prices, so that P1 world over P2 world equals one. That tells us something about the slope of the consumption possibilities curve, as we'll soon see. Suppose that before there was access to trade, production in this country occurred at this point, which would indicate that roughly equal amounts were made of the two goods. Now, access to trade is opened. What that tells us is that aside from the option of moving along PPC from this point, suppose that they decide that actually they would like to consume some more of good one than just this amount. Well, they have one option, and that is to produce more of good one. But in order to do that, in order to move over by one unit to the right, they have to stop making more than a unit of good two, right? Because the slope of PPC here is greater than one. Well, the other option now is that, oh, we want to consume one more unit of good one. All we have to do is sell a unit of good two. So access to trade gives them the option of moving in this direction now at a slope of one. If they wanted to have more of good two and less of good one, then they could also go in this direction. But notice that this is less of a good deal, because it turns out that if they want to consume another unit of good two, there's a cheaper way of doing that, and that is to produce it. So access to trade allows us to move consumption away from the point of production. But here's the thing, if this is true, if we can now consume anywhere along a line of slope one, then there's no reason we should continue to produce at this point anymore. In fact, you might notice that if we switch to producing more of good two and less of good one, so if we move production in this direction, that's going to expand the set of bundles we have access to. So we'll continue to make this shift until we get to a tangency between CPC and the point of production. So now this will be point A. That indicates how much the country produces. In terms of consumption, however, that can be chosen anywhere along CPC. So CPC is a line that has slope equal to the ratio of prices internationally, and that has to make contact with production possibilities curve, but it will do so so that it includes the most possible bundle, so that it's as far as possible from the origin, which means that we will find it at the tangency point. So if this country continues to want to consume roughly equal amounts of the two goods, then their consumption point will be somewhere in this area, let's say here. And so what Access to Trade has done is, first, it changed the mix of inputs the country produces. So they've shifted towards making much more of good two and less of good one. And it allowed the country to expand consumption of both goods. Another way to look at it is all of the area that's beyond PPC but under CPC, those are bundles that are newly available for consumption because of trade. Let's review the components we have here so far. So we have the production possibilities curve in blue. This is determined simply by the technology that the country has and the inputs. Then we had the initial point of production on PPC, right? So by definition, the country was restricted to producing only somewhere on this line or under it. Well, before trade, however much the country consumed was how much the country produced. So in determining this initial point, there were two factors to take into account. One is the production possibilities curve itself and its slope at different points, and the other was the preferences of the inhabitants of that country. After there's access to trade, that has expanded the available options for consumption from this to this. Now production will occur at precisely this point, and that is the point on PPC where it is tangent to the consumption possibilities curve, so where its slope equals the ratio of prices internationally. So the point of production now will depend only on the production capabilities and international prices. It no longer depends on preferences anymore. Preferences will determine where on this line the country consumes. So they might consume here at this point B, as I've marked it here, but that's not something that we can know for sure. Perhaps now that, compared to before, good one is relatively cheaper, perhaps they'll consume a lot more of good one, and so point B might be somewhere around here. Wherever that choice is, we know that they have to be better off than initially, simply because now the set of options has expanded. There's nothing that was a possibility before that is no longer a possibility now. There are more options. It must be that the country is better off. The other thing we can see here, if we assume that B is indeed the point of consumption, is we can mark imports and exports of this country. So we could see, for example, that compared to what is produced, a relatively smaller amount of good two is consumed. So that's exports of good two. And more of good one than is produced is consumed. So in terms of what effects will this have on people and firms in this country, well, you could see that it very much depends on which industry you happen to be in. So for good one, price before, which is indicated by the slope of PPC, so the relative cost internally of making good one was relatively high. It was higher than one, meaning that good one was more expensive than good two. But because the prices are equal internationally, that will now be also the ratio of prices internally. So between before trade to after trade, good one has become relatively cheaper. Less of it is produced in this country. Good two, by contrast, has become more valuable and more of it is produced. So depending on which industry you happen to work in, trade may be good or bad news for you. However, taken all together, we can see that the country has more options.